I'm Gareth Davis and you have just entered the Davis Locker. It is quite simply the greatest movie-based infotainment show on the entire interwebs. You need some proof? Easy. Head on over to our YouTube channel and check out our previous content. And while you're there, you may as well hit that subscribe button and the notification bell so you know exactly when we post new content. Right, it's Wednesday the 18th of March, and yes, we're still in lockdown. The big news today is that all the schools are going to be closed from Friday, so you get to have your little angels around you 24/7. Here's a question for you. Where are the Andes? Yeah, at the end of your armies, Gromit. Still, one of the biggest pieces of advice to combat COVID-19 is to wash your hands thoroughly. Not only do you need to rub them every which way but loose, but make sure you're doing it for at least 20 seconds. So that could be the first two verses of Baby Shark. Ooh, stay with me, because there is an alternative. Happy Birthday. Here, sung in a beautiful rendition by Sebastian Stan.
Happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you, happy birthday, fucking everyone. Happy birthday to you.
Okay, now to movie news, and this is big news. Apparently, there is a cut of the film musical Cats that includes their buttholes. Twitter user Jack Waz outlined the story.
A VFX producer friend of a friend was hired in November to finish some of the 400 effect shots in Cats. His entire job was to remove the CGI buttholes that had been inserted a few months before, which means that somewhere out there exists a butthole cut of Cats.
Now don't make an ass of yourself. Next time you tweet a tweet, make sure you use the hashtag #ReleaseTheButtholeCut. And talking about Twitter, we're available across social media at The Davis Locker on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram. Right, it's day 3 of the Coronavirus Film Challenge. Let's take a recap. So if you are showing signs of COVID-19, the advice is self-isolate for 14 days. And then we found out that the coronavirus also has 14 letters. So for the next 2 weeks, we're producing a daily vlog where we'll use an individual letter to start a film title. We'll all give it a watch and give our opinions in the comments below. Day 1 was 28 days later, and yesterday was Heat. And today, we're talking about The Evil Dead. So there you go, you're all up to speed. I hope you've watched the first two episodes. If not, go back and take them a look and make sure you get into the comments on YouTube and across social media. Right, before we crack on, as always, we need to rummage in the snack drawer. So tonight I've gone for the classic combo of grapes and chocolate. In honour of musical feline buttholes everywhere, I've gone for the Kit Kat.
2 hours later.
Over 20 years before he was chasing Spider-Man around with his camera, Sam Raimi was directing his debut feature, the horror extravaganza, The Living Dead. It thrust Bruce Campbell into stardom, and it is an absolute cult classic. Here's what the IMDb Parents Guide says. Violence and gore, severe. Frightening and intense scenes, severe. Sex and nudity, moderate. Profanity, mild. Alcohol, drugs and smoking, mild. I mean, what else do you want? In terms of a plot, 5 friends go up to a cabin in the woods where they find unspeakable evil lurking in the forest. They find the Book of the Dead and its taped translation. And it's when this tape is played is when evil is unleashed. And one by one, each of these kids get possessed. And with only one person left remaining, Bruce Campbell's character Ash, it's up to him to survive and fight the Evil Dead.
Ah! don't care what happens to her. She's your girlfriend. You take care of her.
How about that? Now, this is a stone-cold horror classic, and in some ways reminds me of the first entry in the Coronavirus Film Challenge, 28 Days Later, in that its budget was very small, but the end product does not suffer at all. It's fantastic. With a mixture of gore and black comedy, it really has everything you want. One of my favourite authors growing up as a lad was Stephen King, and actually the film was shown to him, and his glowing endorsement, which was used for TV ads and posters, really sold it to the public and helped with the success of this film. In terms of the small budget, this film almost didn't get completed. It was only that Bruce Campbell put his family's property up as collateral that Sam Raimi could not only finish the film, but also blow it up to 35 mil, which was required for a theatrical release. He was so grateful for his friend putting up this financial contribution that he put him down as a co-producer of the film. Not only was Bruce Campbell providing financial assistance, he was also trying to help as much as he could in lots of other roles. For example, the opening sequence where the evil is travelling along the pond, Bruce Campbell is actually in waders pushing Sam Raimi in a little dinghy so he could get the shot. So there you go, that's my little roundup. As ever, we want to encourage discussion across our social media and on YouTube. Please let me know what your favourite scenes are. Do you prefer Sam Raimi's horror to his Spider-Man films? And finally, what is Bruce Campbell's best role ever? Now, as I've said before, if you're not following us on YouTube, we would love it if you were to head on over there, hit that subscribe button and the notification bell so you know exactly when we post new videos. Now, if you prefer your content in audio form, we are now available on Apple, Spotify and Google Podcasts. Go and subscribe wherever you download your podcasts. And finally, we have a lovely little website, www.thedavislocker.com. There you'll find our news, reviews, trailer Top Trumps episodes and any original content that we've produced. Now before I go, I just wanted to confirm the film for tomorrow. Beginning with the letter C, it's obviously Contagion. So many people suggested that we just couldn't leave it off the list. Now we are taking suggestions for the letter O, so please let me know what films we should include in the comments below and on social media. Right, I've been Gazza D, this is The Davis Locker, see ya!